This week's What's My Line panel. First, our favorite party mixer, Soupy Sales.
Thank you. Thank you, and thank you, Chet Gould. It's a pleasure to welcome back to our panelists this beautiful opera singer, and her name is Joanna Simon.
I'd like to introduce the only man who sees more movies than I do, and he does because he's a critic, the famous critic Leonard Harris.
All right, now, how many of you remember that old song, When Frances Dances With Me? Nobody, right? Well, this Frances is not going to dance with me. She hasn't so far, but she is going to stand next to me. Arlene Frances.
And here's the man that makes beautiful music for all of us to dance to, Larry Blyden.
Good day, all bodies.
Hello, Larry.
Everybody is tan and brown today, except Susie, who's black and white and red. That means nothing to anybody anywhere.
Yes.
But it does give them a chance to set the scene back there. And so now, would our first challenger enter and sign in, please? Dolly Tingle. Where are you from, Miss Tingle?
Westport, Connecticut.
Okay, panel. Dolly Tingle is a professional artist and designer. She was recently commissioned to create a design in needlepoint, and we will now show the audience how her design is to be used. And let's begin with Leonard Harris.
I knew you'd give me the chance to say hello, Dolly.
Lovely, thank you.
And I'm sorry you did. The question is where or how this design is going to be used.
Right. How it's to be used.
It's going to be used in some way other than a museum. Is it going to be used on something like... Well, on something that is used in another way, something of use to us other than just looking at it.
Yes.
Yes.
That is, let's say, something like a blanket or a stamp, but, of course, not one of those.
Right.
Is it going to be used on a blanket or a stamp?
Yes.
Thank you. Is that it?
Well, there are two things there.
Yeah, it's going to be used on a blanket or a stamp. I can't believe it's going to be used on a blanket. Is it going to be used on a stamp?
That's correct. Yeah. That's exactly where it's going to be used.
Dolly, it really was worth having lunch with you.
And they said the man couldn't act. My goodness. Well, I'm awed. That took about 2 seconds to get that. He was commissioned to create a needlepoint design for a 1973 Christmas stamp. Do you have it with you? Did you bring the actual original needlepoint design? This is the needlepoint that she's done, and it's all been framed. And look at that. Isn't that lovely? Can you get a close-up of that, Lloyd? Well, just leave it there because it's really pretty, and they may take a shot of it again later. Where is that now? Can you? Who owns that?
The U.S. government owns it, the Postal Service, and actually it would be based in Washington, but it's going to travel around the country to big city post offices.
It's really charming. Why did the stamp committee want a needlepoint design?
Well, needlepoint and all the old crafts are coming back now. It's the old-fashioned thing that's become popular.
But you know, it is popular and a lot of people do it. How did they happen to come to you for it?
Well, I'm a professional artist, and I was commissioned by Mr. Stephen Dohannes, who is the chairman of the Citizens Advisory Stamp Committee, and he knew that I could do needlepoint as well as design.
How long did it take to make it?
About 10 days, day and night.
Ooh, yeah. Really? Doesn't that draw your tongue out when you try to lick it?
Mr. Tingle, I will certainly not subject you to this indignity any longer. That's beautiful, and it's marvelous. Leonard was very cheeky. Right. I'm sorry. I'm getting cues here like mad. Here are the stamps, in case anybody didn't know. There. Can you get a shot of these, Lloyd?
Yes.
That's the stamp that grew out of the design. And you can get them, I guess, anywhere now, can't you? Are they on sale?
At your local post office.
Have they made posters or anything of these?
Yes, they have.
That's
that
terrific.
That will be in post offices.
Thank you very much for being with us on What's My Line.
Beautiful.
We'll be back with more of What's My Line after this message. Before our next challenger enters, just want to say good luck on your opening tonight at the Bitter End.
See? Thank you. I invite everybody to come down and see it.
Okay, now would our next challenger enter and sign in, please. Frank Andrews. Where are you from, sir?
Originally from Buffalo, New York.
Okay, panel. Frank Andrews provides a personal service, and we will show the audience what his line is. And let's begin the questioning with our resident soprano, Joanna Simon.
Thank you. Is this personal service that you perform, do you perform it on both men and women?
Yes.
Equally?
No.
Well, I tell you, he doesn't, because he knows, but it really doesn't make any difference.
Uh-huh.
So go ahead.
It isn't central
to the problem.
I see. Are people made in some way better after you have performed the service?
I think so.
Is it something that we can see that's better? Is there some physical change?
Not inherent in what he actually does.
Not
one down and nine to go, Leonard.
I've always wanted to say to somebody like that, let's be frank and earnest. That only leaves me earnest, doesn't it? That's why I've never said that before now.
And you never will again.
And I never will again. Does it involve, if you'll pardon the expression, the laying on of hands? Do you touch the person?
Not really.
Let's be frank and earnest.
Right, not really, no.
Earnestly and frankly, no. Arlene?
Is there anything, do you use any kind of implements in your service?
Yes.
Are they implements that you can hold in your hand?
Yes.
Do you, with these implements, do you touch something else?
How do you mean, Arlene?
If he's a piano tuner, he'd touch the piano.
No, we have to say no to him.
No.
Three down, seven to go, Soupy.
You don't touch anything with these implements?
No, not really.
No.
Well, what do
no.
you have them around for? All right? He just likes to carry things. When you perform this service, Frank, could you come to my apartment?
Yes.
This?
Yes, I can.
Would the apartment look better after you finished?
No, I don't think so.
Four down and six to go, Joanna.
Does what you do have anything to do with physical exercise?
No, it does not.
Five down and five to go, Leonard.
You would carry this implement or implements into Soupy's apartment, for example, and it would look no better. You would not touch the implements to him. You would not touch the implements to anything. Would you test?
Well, if for example, everything eventually is touched to something.
No, I mean, in the course of what these implements had to do and the work that he had to do, Frank.
They might be touched to something, but it wouldn't make any difference.
Wouldn't make any difference, okay. Would you test anything with these implements?
I have to say, in a way, yes.
Feel free to say yes anytime you want.
Well, I don't know what it means, Leonard, and I wouldn't take it too seriously. He knows what it means. I don't. Don't take it too seriously.
That makes two of us,
and
right?
And push on. Yeah.
All right.
Now I don't know what he does anymore.
The implements. Is it a single implement?
It's a simple kind of a single kind of implement.
Is it something that you small enough to carry in your hand and move around with?
Yes. Yes, you can.
Does it have anything to do with the furnishings or objects in the apartment?
No.
Six down and four to go, Arlene.
Is there anything entertaining about what you do, or...
Some people think so.
Would you be considered in any way a performer?
Some people think of it as that. I don't, but some people do.
Well, what do you think, Larry?
I don't think he's a performer. I don't think he's a performer.
I want to say no to that.
7-3 to go, Soupy.
He's not a performer, but
there's something entertaining about entertaining it, but he's not a performer. All right, Soupy?
He makes you happy when he leaves.
No.
Kenny Youngman, 1923. Let me see. But it's some kind of a performance. But
he said no.
But he said no, but you said there's something entertaining.
Right.
Yes.
I'd like to pass.
Joanna?
I would like to establish what we've, I think, already established, but just so it's clear to me. Right. You come into somebody's house.
You can.
I can.
You can. And then you do something that is entertaining to them, but not necessarily to you.
No, not really, Joanna. You can't really say that.
And you bring this peculiar, very small instrument.
You're assuming that because he came to your house, he came there to do something to your house. He just can go there. The likelihood of it is fairly remote.
That's right.
How you like that one, folks?
All right. Now, tell me something. Out of the blue from Soupy Sales, do you deal with animals?
No.
8-2 to go, Leonard.
This is something that some people would regard as entertaining, but you wouldn't.
That's right.
Do you have anything to do with the occult?
Yes, I do.
Are you a fortune teller? Read a crystal ball.
Read a crystal ball. 9-1 to go. Arlene, you want to try something?
Any kind of magic?
No.
No kind of magic. Predicts the future with cards.
Uh-huh.
With cards. Frank's a professional psychic, and I must say he really does some fantastic things. What sort of cards do you use?
I use tarot cards.
Now, what can you learn?
Well, the tarot cards can give you the past, the present, and the future. And they can take in almost any direction, actually.
Suppose that somebody comes to you and you say, ah, I see in your future that there's going to be a big catastrophe, probably in about 20 minutes. Now, is that inevitable that there's going to be...
No, it's not. It's not. Because there's been a few cases where they were supposed to have an accident and they didn't take the trip, so it didn't happen. I've seen that.
Glad to hear that.
It's from that sort of thing that we get the expression, I shouldn't have got up this morning. How do you usually work with the cards?
Well, I hand them to you, and you can do the shuffling. Sometimes I do the shuffling, and they're cut in various ways and laid out in many, many patterns. There's 78 cards in all, and each card you see is like a story.
Could you show us a sort of a shorthand version of it?
Okay. Usually it takes an hour per person, so we can only give, I guess, a few minutes.
All right. Terrific. Let's have a shot at it. Jennifer, what do you say? Panel, come on up and everybody take a seat. Okay. It goes down to its mark, Bob. Here we go. That's yours. I'll sit over here, if I may, and see if I can get it on the edge. Yeah, well, here we are. There we are. Now then, won't you? There's your chair, Arlene.
Oh, I know.
Everybody's going to get a chair.
Order here.
Bartender? Oh, I thought you were going to say hit me. I really do. I had a bet with a drink. Now, what happens, Frank?
Well, what we're going to do here is we're going to do it very quickly. I'm going to ask you each to pull three cards. Just hold the cards in front of you, okay? And let's hold them up. Let's
see. All right, I'll hold mine up.
Okay, and I'm going to read these off.
Hold them this way.
All right, now, what you have here, what we start here, is talks about a job, talks about an opportunity, and with it, it says good fortune. But it brings in a lot of work. But this is something new. This is something new that's coming up.
Oh, I'm so glad to hear that. I'm getting so sick of you, son, Soupy.
I just heard your option drop.
Okay, how about Arlene? Okay. You want to hold yours up, Arlene, so I can get a shot at him over there?
You'll have to pull two more, because there's not enough here to talk about.
That's typical of me. There's never enough to talk about.
That'll be the day.
Did I get any better?
Well, it just talks about a quarrel. It talks about a little argument going on. It says with a young person. It's not very much here. And it says a household upside down. For a while, your house is upside down.
Terrific! Oh, my good news.
Okay, should we go to you?
What's going on?
Pull another one. This is about money. This is a good one about finances here.
just ruined
it. No, you got a very good one. It talks about you going out of the country. And
that's good.
Yeah, it's really leaving the country.
Listen, a walk will do him good.
And it also brings in finances. You're going to probably, it looks like property maybe, but out of the country, not in the United States. You know, like buying property, which says very good for resale.
Good. Alcatraz.
I need a good shirt with someone hanging from a tree.
Oh, well,
and I'm afraid that's very bad news.
Well, that's the hanged man. Actually, you have it upside down. It should be the other way.
Hold it up.
Okay, you pull one more.
Thank God.
Go ahead. This has to do with your regular profession, and it's sort of like, a group of you together in your regular profession, and that's what you do.
Yes.
And, can I just move this over a little bit? Yeah. Well,
you're going to be hung by the heels.
No, there's sort of like there's going to be a lot of arguments about a particular performance in the contract, the signing of papers.
Always are.
The West Coast. They're going toward the West Coast. No, it looks like California out in there. But it does come through. In other words, it looks very good. But it looks like probably some kind of a strike because it says a lot of people are going to get together and argue over this.
You better come over to my house. It's upside down.
How about old Soup?
This is very good. Pull one more. Let's get
one more.
Okay. Yeah, because I need another one to tell the story.
Okay.
And one more. You're pulling money cards.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, wow. You pulled what we call the promising outlook, but let's turn it the other way, because otherwise it doesn't mean promising.
Oh, good.
No, but you pulled some nice things with money here. It's like any kind of investments paying off, something paying off for you. You pulled
I bought one. 7 up when it was 6.
Can we each draw another card or two? Or are we out of time? We're out of time. I'm having more fun than I had in a long time. Frank, thank you for being with us on What's My Line. We'll be back with more What's My Line after this.
I know what the problem is at your house. My kids are coming over there. Listen, it's time now for the special feature of What's My Line, the appearance of our mystery guest. And that means it's blindfold time panel. So are they all in place? Then would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please. Okay, panel, we'll go one question at a time. Fate's law prevails. You have about 2 minutes, and let's start with Arlene Francis.
Well, that was a nice reception, mystery guest. Are you best known to audiences because of your work in television?
Yes, I am.
Oh, swell.
Soupy, is that because you're on a show of your own?
No.
Joanna?
Are you a singer or dancer?
No.
Leonard?
Are you essentially an actor?
No.
Arlene?
Oh, you're not an actor. But you are seen on television. Are you a sports figure?
Yes.
Soupy?
Uh-huh. Are you a sports broadcaster for ABC?
No.
Joanna?
Sore about
it. Sore.
Are you either involved in football or baseball?
No, neither.
Leonard?
But you are a TV sportscaster. Let me guess at another.
That's an assumption. That hasn't been established.
All right. Okay. Are you a TV sportscaster?
No.
Arlene?
But are you an active participant in a sport?
No.
Not now. Soupy?
Oh.
What? Oh, not now.
Oh, not now. And I thought about it before. Would it be with horse racing?
No.
Joanna?
Would it be with boxing?
Yes.
Leonard?
You're not active now, and you were a boxer.
Oh, was he a boxer?
All right. Are you in a heavyweight boxer?
No.
Arlene?
Now, wait a minute. You said you were known in television.
Right.
And you're a boxer. Do you do television commercials?
Yes.
Rocky Graziano!
Thank you.
Soupy, you should have got me.
Got to get the sport. Yeah. That was a good voice, Rob.
Terrific voice.
Good voice.
I learned that from Pseudo Capaldi.
I thought we had him there for a minute. Listen, you know, you were a fighter. What? And then you became an actor. What was the hardest thing? Learning lines? What was tough?
Well, learning the line was the worst thing in the world. I still can't learn lines. I whenever I do a commercial, I tell a guy, please make those cards, cue cards, put them up, please, and give me about 4 days to study them. That's only a 30-second commercial.
What's the first thing you ever learned?
The first thing I ever learned, I was doing a show with Martha Ray in 1955, and I learned Shakespeare. I don't remember it, but something about Martha, something with the... The words of Martha's song from the opera, Norma. It's my wife's name. I should remember my name. Norma. I sang a piece with Martha Ray and Cesar Murillo on the show.
And you remembered that?
I don't remember it now, but I got so mixed up doing my lines, I still get mixed up. I really.
Where do you get home and your wife finds out you couldn't remember her name?
Norma,
that'll be it.
No, but I really. I still get. I'm not an actor. I mean, like you on a stage. I just do. If I talk like you, I'd be broke. So it's, you know.
Whatever you do, wait here. We don't want you to be broke. We're gonna break for commercial. We'll be right back. When Rocky and I first started to work together, occasionally I was on a show, and every time he'd come on the show, he would greet me by saying, "Hey, how you doing? Anybody bothering you?" And people heard, and nobody did. This is my pal Rocky. We'll see you around. Goodbye, everybody.
Thank you very much.
Jack Gould speaking for What's My Line? A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was recorded.